Are you a WinUI dev? Ever get stuck trying to customize a XAML control? Well, today on Zero to XAML, with me, the XAML Llama, we are going to take you on a journey and see how we can take a flip view, customize it with removing the buttons, and understand why that might not work right away, and how we can unstick ourselves and move forward with our development. So, I will assume you've already installed the WinUI workload, and that you hopefully have done a little bit of Windows development before, but if not, we'll get you up to speed. That's the point here. So we're going to create a blank app package, WinUI desktop. I'm going to call this FlipView Debugging. And so we're going to create this project here. Magic will happen. Visual Studio will open it up. Whoosh. Here we go. And we're going to have our standard template here, right? Let's just for now put our flip view in here so I can go to the WinUI 3 Gallery app that is available in the Microsoft Store. I can download this. I'm on the flip view page here. We can see how the flip view works, and I can just copy this code over. Now, this code, of course, assumes that we have some images to display in our flip view. So I'm going to create a folder in our assets here. I'm just going to call it llamas, and I'm going to go over to my llama picture folder and drag and drop some of those in here. And so now we have some llama folders. You can see I've grabbed these from Unsplash. It's a great website for pretty photos, and shows some identifiers and artist names here for tracking where they came from. I like to keep those there, but it's going to be a little bit harder to reference, so we'll see what's going on there in a second on adding these into our XAML. But one thing to notice here is you can see there's this build action is set to none by default. We actually want to change this to content, right? So now we have content as the build action for all those images that I selected. So that's going to allow our application to reference them. Otherwise, they wouldn't be included in the package, and we would not have our images. And so now I can go into XAML here, and if I start trying to modify one of these, we can actually see Visual Studio is giving us hints for these images paths. And so I can just click on that and change that out here. Now you'll notice that the original ones in the sample were MS AppX, and the ones that Visual Studio inserted just have a slash here. And these are basically equivalent. It's just a shortcut here, so don't need to worry about that. And so I can just go grab some of my other images here quick and include those into our flip view. And I need an extra line here since we have an extra image. So now if I just grab that last one. And one last thing to sometimes remember with the old template is after buttons, I'm just going to do that. And now we can run this project and see our flip view in action here. Dragging that from my other monitor here. So we have our llamas in our flip view. And we can see it's a little bit smaller within the view of our window. That's because the sample had a specific width and height set here. But that's fine. But let's say, you know, by default, the flip view has these buttons here. Maybe we're trying to make just a little scrolling automatic gallery that's just showing images. We don't want the user to interact with that, or we want to control it with a pips pager. There could be a few different reasons why we might not want to have these buttons on top of our image display here. So how do we customize this, right? How do we get rid of these buttons? And so the first thing we really need to do to be able to do that in this case is modify the template of the flip view. And that's the power where we get a lot of flexibility with XAML, so that we can customize how controls look without changing their necessarily underlying behavior, though we're going to do that in this case. And so let's, the question is, how do we find out where this template is and what it is? A great resource that I use all the time for that is just going to GitHub. And so here we have the Microsoft UI-xaml repository in the Microsoft org. And this is where we can find code for WinUI. And if you're using a specific version of WinUI, especially an older version, you might want to find the WinUI 3/release branch that matches your latest release. So these should these branches should hold the latest incremental version for each of those minor versions here. So if you need a older version of the XAML, you can grab stuff from there. Though usually main is sufficient, especially things like FlipView haven't changed in a while, so you can usually just grab stuff from main. It should be fine. So in this case, I'm going to search for FlipView, and I'll just add XAML here too, just to narrow things down. And so sometimes you'll see a few different XAML files here. The main one that we want in this case is the theme resources. Sometimes, if you saw when I removed XAML from here, there's actually where this like code lives is usually where these partial H and CPP files are. We'll get to those later in our debugging efforts. But sometimes the XAML file for a control will be right there. It depends on kind of how old the control is and what control you're looking for. But those are kind of the two XAML files to look at. So one hint too that you're in the wrong place is if you go to the theme resources and you only see the static resources and not the actual template, which is what we're looking for here, then look for that other XAML file. And so here, this is actually what we kind of copy this default FlipView style that's targeting FlipView. So this actually represents the code in XAML with how this control looks and all the pieces that make it up. And we can see if we scroll down here past all the visual states, we get to those four buttons for either horizontal or vertical scrolling that we want to remove in our use case here. So I'm just going to copy this style out of GitHub. And I just need to make sure I grab the whole enchilada here. Okay. And so back in Visual Studio, this is a large chunk of XAML that I'm copying in my project. So for best practices, I want to create my own separate file to store this in so that I can keep track of one, where it came from, and you know the purpose of it is, of that it's trying to achieve here. So we are going to go and add a new folder. I'm going to call it styles. And I'm just going to add a new item here and filter in on WinUI, and we want a resource dictionary, right? So this is what allows us to store XAML in other files, and I'm just going to call this FlipView. And we don't need any local stuff to reference here, so I'm going to get rid of that line. I'm just going to paste this style in, and so again, it's targeting FlipView. I'm going to give it a custom name, right, since we are customizing it here. And just so that we know that we are referencing this style directly, I'm going to set the background to red so that we have a very clear indicator that we are using this style. And so that's what I'm going to start here now. In most cases, hopefully things should work. Sometimes the styles will reference other things. That's not the case with this one. So sometimes you might need to tweak things around or include a XAML namespace up here. But that should be hopefully pretty straightforward if you encounter that. In this case, we should be good. Now, in order to include this new resource dictionary that we've put in a separate file, we need to actually add that to our app resources. So I can go in here and I want to merge in a dictionary. You can actually see Visual Studio IntelliSense Copilot here helping us out with just adding that file. So this is adding this FlipView XAML style that I just added to our project in here with the rest of our XAML styles. And then the last thing we need to do is just tell our FlipView to use that style. So I can use style and I can add a resource here, and I can actually see it giving me a suggestion of that custom FlipView style. So now I've customized our FlipView. So I can run this and we should see it using our custom style here. And voila, we have our red background, right? And we have our buttons. So first thing we might think of, right, with XAML visibility, let's collapse the buttons and get rid of them that way. So I can actually go into our FlipView template now, right? And for each of these buttons, I can set the visibility to collapsed. And add that for each one of those. And I'll rerun this here. And we'll see what happens. All right, it looks like it works. And then they're still there. So what's happened, right? Like our buttons, we set them collapse. Why are they ever visible? And so this is kind of a thing to understand with how XAML works and XAML templating works, right? Like, a lot of controls try to not always do everything in XAML and try to manipulate things in code. And one really kind of key indicator of that and factor in that you can kind of detect that that might be the case is when the XAML thing in the template has a name. Like, these do, these buttons have names, right? The main reason to ever name something in XAML is to reference it elsewhere. And so that can sometimes be in the Visual State Manager, right? So the Visual State Manager up here is doing a whole bunch of stuff when different things happen in order to, you know, like when you're hovering over the button, it's going to change properties and other things like that. So Visual State Manager, kind of common thing that will manipulate the state. And so we can kind of maybe search for these button names in our XAML here. And there's just like the one reference, right? This is the only place it's referenced. So if it's not the Visual State Manager changing things, then it might be something in code behind, right? And let's go look at the code, right? So that's something we can do on GitHub. And so I can, again, search for FlipView. And I pointed these out before, right? There's the partial H and CPP files that represent the code here for this control. So I'm going to go into the code here. I'm going to search for that previous button horizontal. I could also just do a global search for that on the GitHub repo. And so if I go down eventually, so there's a few different references here. And in one part here, we see the string, right? And this is the string that's representing that string we saw in XAML because it's in this onApply template function. That's the function that basically hooks up the XAML to the code of this templated control. And so in this particular case, we can see that it's storing the reference from the XAML part in this other other variable, right? In this other field that happens to have the same name, right? Fortunately for us, it has the same name. Otherwise, you know, you're gonna have to look for where the string is and where it's getting the template part from in on apply template and kind of figure out what's that getting mapped to in terms of code. In this case, it's got a similar name, so all of our search results here map there. And so if we kind of keep jumping around to see where this is referenced, right, this is getting all kind of initialized here. And then if I get to this part here where it's like apply new visibilities, well, what's going on here? What is this function? This is a function called change visual state. So this is interacting with the visual states of the control, right? Which is what drives the visual state manager. But the control itself can also be listening to that or manipulating that, right? It works in both directions, either changing the state programmatically or reacting to the change in state programmatically. And so that's what this function is doing, is that somewhere in the code here, when the state is changing, they're manipulating the visibility of these buttons, right? So here are each of the buttons, and we're setting the visibility based on a whole bunch of other properties that the control is trying to kind of tangle together and decide whether it should be like showing the horizontal or the vertical buttons, right? Because maybe you've changed the orientation of the control, right? So that's what this code is doing here and why it exists, and there's a valid reason for it to do so. But in our particular use case, when we want to get rid of the buttons, that doesn't help us, right? We don't want the control to be in charge of that for us. And so another aspect you can see here is that these are all in if blocks, which is great for us, right? They're basically checking, did it find that part of XAML named with that button, right? If it did, then there's something that's represented in that field. And if not, then that's going to be null. And so it's actually doing the null check here basically to see like whether I should try to manipulate something that I have a reference to or not. So basically our two solutions are we could rename the part, right? If we give this a different name, then the control won't find it. Or in our case too, since we really don't even care about the buttons all, we can just delete these, right? And then that on apply template code won't find it. The field won't be set. And then that code will just be do a no op, right? It'll ignore it because there's nothing there. And so now we can run our FlipView package. bring our app back over here, and we don't have our buttons anymore, right? So if this has focus, I can still interact with it with the keyboard, but you know, I can maybe have a pips pager, or I could, you know, just have this on a timer rotating through images. And so, you know, this is the first step in our journey of customizing this control, but now we've kind of debugged what was going on, what was wrong, and how we can fix and customize that in our XAML tools and with the power of GitHub and open source. So in many cases, if controls are developed really well, they really anticipate the ability to not have those different template parts in those spots, right? So sometimes, though, that those have slipped through the cracks. So if you remove something from a template and it crashes, then that's a bug, right? controls should be resistant to template modifications. But it is something to think about if you're developing your own controls, that you want to be able to sure you're checking and not assuming that those parts are always going to be in your XAML template. And so hopefully this has helped you learn a lot more about XAML, how to debug XAML, and how to continue to build great apps on Windows. Happy XAMLing!